Two.
Hi there, everybody. I'm Laura, and I'm here at Namaste. We're using this beautiful back room today to do a nice basic Hatha practice for you. So this is going to be available for anybody, whether you practice a lot or none at all. Just come on, get on your mat, and take some deep breaths and stretch with us. I have Melissa and Linda with me today, so welcome. We're going to start on our backs today. So take your time, make your way there. If you have any props at home that would make you more comfortable, you want to put your head on a blanket or use a bolster or anything underneath your knees, you're welcome to do that. You can stretch all the way out, or if there's another place that you're more comfortable, bending the knees, bringing the knees together, anything that sounds appealing to you. So we just want to use these first few moments here to find a little stillness, a little quiet. And that can be really challenging when we're going through sort of a difficult time. So be patient with yourself. Try not to force anything. And just agree to move through your practice here today with us without judgment. Swallow and hollow out the back of the throat. Shift the jaws from side to side. Soften the space between the eyebrows. Move the head around a little bit. Release any tension from the neck. Let go of any extra energy that you're hanging on to in the hands and the feet. Notice all the places that you're connected to the earth. Those are all places where you're being held up and supported. Let yourself sink into those spaces. So while we're still noticing the physical body here, just pay attention to any spots that might feel a little tight or that might feel sore, places where you're holding on. And just treat those spaces with a little extra compassion today as you move through your practice. Notice any differences from side to side. Close the eyes if that's available to you. Bring the lips one to one, but try to separate the teeth and bring the tongue forward a little bit, creating some space in the back of the throat. And begin to bring your attention to your breath. We're not trying to make any big changes here or do anything different. We're just increasing the awareness of the breath that you brought with you. So noticing the texture of the breath, whether it's smooth or choppy. Noticing the depth of the breath, whether it's shallow or deep and full. Acknowledging that this is the breath that you brought with you today. It will get you through your practice today. It will leave with you when you leave your mat today. And it will change throughout your practice. So a big part of the work that we do is just paying attention to the breath and noticing how the different postures affect the breath. So if you notice the breath becomes shallow or choppy at any points, then take a pause, maybe find a different place to work, explore some stillness for a little bit, and find a place where you can breathe deeply again. I would say don't worry about what anybody else is doing, but you're going to be doing this pretty much by yourself, so you can let that go. That's always true, though. The next time you breathe in more deeply on purpose. Let the breath really move into the lowest part of the lungs and visualize it as it goes up across the heart to the collarbones and back down. With each inhale today, we'll find length and opening. And with each exhale, we work to release and let go. with this new fuller breath, see if maybe you can make your exhales even twice as long as your inhales are. Sometimes it helps to count. Feel free to count maybe up to 3 or 4 or 5, whatever makes sense to you as you inhale. And then as you exhale, perhaps lengthening that exhale to 6 or 7 or 8. No need to rush the breath or effort with the breath. But watch the breath. And sometimes when our minds are busy and full of stresses and concerns, it can be really difficult to bring attention solely to the breath. So if that's happening to you, don't worry about it. Again, work with compassion here and be patient. Give your mind time to quiet. So we'll begin to add some movement to the breath. And like I mentioned before, each of these postures that we'll do through our practice today will challenge the breath in different ways. So just continually bringing your attention back to the inhales and the exhales, even though the mind will wander at home practicing, there are a lot of distractions. So just continuing to remind yourself to find this breath again. The next time you breathe in, stretch the arms way up above the head. Deep lengthening inhale. You can draw all the muscles onto the bones if that feels good. And then open the mouth and exhale. One more time, let's inhale and stretch. And open the mouth and exhale. So we're going to keep the arms extended above the head. If you have something underneath your head right now, it might be a good time to move it off to the side, just so that the back can be flat on the mat. Keep the arms up, keep the shoulders and the sitting bones attached to the earth, and just walk the hands and feet over to the right. So this is not a big movement, it's a small, subtle movement. We're kind of creating a C shape with the spine. And most importantly, lengthening the left side. So if you'd like, you can cross your ankles. After a few breaths, if the body softens and relaxes, you might feel like you can walk the hands or feet over a little farther, but no need to really push through this. Just stay somewhere where you can breathe deeply. Think about lengthening with the breath, creating some space in the left side of the body just with your inhales. And let it go with the exhale. One more good inhale here. As you exhale, walk the hands and feet back to center. We'll pause here for a moment. If this has been uncomfortable to your low back at all, being all stretched out like this, feel free to put the feet on the mat and draw the knees in for a little hug. That must have sounded appealing. Lengthen the legs back out again. Arms back up. So there's not a lot of muscle energy occurring here, so you don't have to really reach and stretch long. It's just a nice extension. And then walk the hands and feet over to the left. So you see the shoulders stay on the mat, the sitting bones stay connected. You can cross the ankle if you'd like. Bringing your attention now to the right side of the body. And notice any differences from side to side. You'll have habits and habitual ways of movement that can cause the body to really be different on both sides. It's good to become aware of those things. So there's literally nothing to do here. You get to just be here. The breath will breathe all on its own. Check in on the jaws, see if anything's tightened up or if it's still soft. One more nice deep inhale here, and then as you exhale, walk the hands and feet back to center again. Take a deep lengthening breath in. As you exhale, pull the belly in, begin to bring onto the mat. So support the low back here. And then draw the knees into the heart one more time. Give yourself a nice hug. If you'd like to move the knees in a figure eight here to give the low back a massage, that can feel good. Take a deep breath in and lengthen the legs straight up. Bring the hands around the backs of the legs. Point, flex the feet. Make some circles with the ankles. Get rid of all those little crackles. That's good. Take the legs out into a wide V. Stretch and support the legs with the hands. You can have a bind anywhere that feels comfortable, keeping the shoulders comfortable. So I'm going to interject here that both Linda and Melissa are pretty flexible. So don't feel bad if you can't reach your feet. It's okay. Bring the hands behind the legs. So from here, we're going to bring the legs into happy baby pose. A little bend in the knees, again, a little rock side to side. Checking out the hips, notice if one side is tighter than the other. Bring the soles of the feet together now. Let the knees open out to the sides. Wrap the hands around the feet. Soften the shoulders. Release the bind of the hands. And once again, just stretch the legs all the way up. Nice, deep, long breath. Bring the sole of the left foot down to the mat. Bring the right knee into the heart. Wrap the arms around the right shin. Make that knee move around in some circles and out to the side. You can take it all the way off the side. Pausing anywhere that feels good, a couple of circles and maybe a breath in stillness somewhere that feels a little tight. Come back to stillness and center and extend the left leg all the way down the mat. Now you can bring that right knee across the body. If it feels good, that right arm can come out to the side for support. It's okay if the right shoulder comes up. The foot doesn't have to come to the floor. It can, or the leg can extend. Breathe into the low back. Bring that knee back to center once again. Carefully pick up the left foot so both knees come in. Stretch both legs up long again. And now bring the left knee in and bring the right foot to the mat. So if you prefer to move this knee around, this left knee around with that right leg extended down the mat, that is absolutely fine. Or you can keep the knee bent. It's up to you. As you move the leg, find any sticky spots, any spots that might be speaking to you, and just pause and breathe there. And whenever you're ready, bring the knee across. Keep a little energy in that right leg, toes just draw in toward the knee a little bit just to protect the knee. And again, the leg can extend or the knee can be bent. Breathe into the low back. Soften the shoulder, relax the hands. Stretch the leg up, deep breath, and then place both feet on the mat. Bring the arms down by the sides. Tuck the shoulder blades together on the back. So we'll have our feet about hip distance apart, about a hand's distance away from the sitting bones. And as you inhale, press into bridge pose. Don't worry about how high up you go, it doesn't matter. You're just creating a little back bend and a nice, beautiful heart opener. Heart openers can really help lift the spirits, bring some joy back into the body. You can stay right here. You can inhale up onto the toes. You can even begin to move with the breath if you'd like. So for some people, exhaling on the lift can be supportive of the low back rather than inhaling as you lift up. So try a bunch of different things here. Do some exploration. If you'd like, you can involve the arms. They can go up and above the head as you lift up. connect breath and movement. So moving with the arms, think about inhaling as you lengthen and lift and open, exhaling as you release back down to the earth. It also helps if you draw the belly in, it helps support the low back as you come back onto the mat. So it's great to have the experience of Linda and Melissa here today because they really listen to their own bodies and they know how to move in ways that their bodies tell them to. So it's never going to look the same for any two people. What you need is going to be often very different than the person next to you needs. So don't try to mimic what anyone else is doing, but just listen to your breath. Time that you lower down onto the earth, pause there. No rush, take your time. Then draw the knees into the heart, wrap the arms around the shins. Bring the arms in T. And then we'll let the knees drift all the way over to the right and the gaze to the left. Now there's lots of variations on these twists. So Linda's using a block that can help support, so it can be good for hips. Good for low back. Melissa's leg is extended. So these are different ways to move into a twist, all based on what you need. If you'd like to take your right hand outside your left leg, you can. And maybe after a few breaths, the gaze turns in the opposite direction of the knees, if it's not already there. See if you can let go of any tension in the feet or the hands. And just as we did when we were stretching before, bring the attention to the left side. Create some space here, just with the breath. So these twists are wonderful for digestion. They're good for the immune system. They're good for the spine. And again, they're a place where you just get to be. Even here, you might want to see if you can make your exhales longer than your inhales. One more nice inhale here. And as you exhale, draw the knees back to center, pulling the belly in toward the spine to support the low back as you unwind. When you get back to the middle, pause here for a moment. Take a lengthening inhale. Make any adjustments with the back that you'd like to do. Draw the knees in if you'd like. And then when you're ready, bring the knees to the left and the gaze to the right. Intentional inhale into the right side. As you exhale, draw the knees back to center. We'll lengthen those legs up long one more time. Deep breath, make some circles with the ankles, and get those crackles going again. Draw the knees into the heart, and then we're going to begin to transition up to table. So you can do this by rocking up and down and just using your momentum, or you can come onto one side and help yourself up with your hands. You'll move through table, through as seated on your way to table. Take your time as you transition. It's a great idea to put something under the knees if you'd like. But once you find your way to hands and knees, go ahead and lengthen your legs out one at a time. Stretch through the heel. Open up the backs of the legs, lengthen through the crown of the head. You can stretch out the feet as well. It's
So being that this is their third practice today, Melissa and Linda were ready right away to go into downward facing dog.
If you are not ready, don't feel bad. Find your way to table. See, it's good to go to yoga, makes you smile. Find your way to table. Begin to move through cat and cow. So as you exhale around the back, draw the belly in, lift the sides of the body up. And then as you inhale, lift the tailbone and lengthen through the crown of the head, opening the heart. So try to avoid tipping the head way back so that you're crunching the bones in the neck. Think about making the spine long as you inhale. Keep a light touch in the hands, keeping the core engaged, the center of gravity in the middle here, which is the only place a center of anything should be. Nice deep breaths. If you'd like now to begin to bring the hips back to the heels, or move from side to side with the breath, or move in some circles with the breath. So try maybe 3 or 4 breaths in movement, and then see if you can find a couple breaths in stillness, somewhere that just seems really appealing today. Keeping in mind that those inhales help us lengthen, the exhales help us to release, draw the belly in, round. They don't really need me. This is all I'm saying. They know what to do. I'm just going to join them in a second. So go ahead and find your way here. So this is Sphinx Pose. We're on the elbows. The body is lengthened. Shoulders are soft. And you're literally being held up by your bones here. So you don't need to use a lot of muscle energy. Keep the low back soft, relax the sitting bones. If you'd like, you can bend the knees and move the feet a little bit side to side to release the low back. You can even take the feet out wide to the edges of the mat. Now we're just getting warmed up, so if you need more than this, you can press into the hands and straighten the arms, but that will really increase the back bend, so you might not be ready for that just yet. Soften the jaws, create that space again. Here, slowly lower, bring the crown of the head, sorry, the forehead down to the earth, and begin to slide the hands back so the fingertips line up with the collarbones. We'll press into the hands, a little baby cobra here, just a gentle lift, keep the elbows right next to the sides. Exhale and lower down. So we're going to float up and down on the breath. If you would prefer, you can take the hands all the way off the mat and come onto the fingertips. Maybe try both and see what's more comfortable for your own shoulders and neck. The next time you lift up, pause there. Stretch and lengthen through the crown of the head. Remember, it doesn't have to be up high. And slowly lower down. Make a pillow for your forehead with your hands. Or if you prefer, you can bring one ear to the earth. Release the low back, bend the knees, move the feet a little bit from side to side if that feels good. And then just find a few moments of stillness. This is a beautiful place to check in with the breath. Let the belly expand into the mat, into the earth. Think about that breath moving around into the back by the tailbone and the kidneys. If you have one ear to the earth, turn the head in the other direction.
bring the head back to center if it's not already there. So we are going to begin to transfer all the way up to downward facing dog. And this can take several phases on the way up. So first, just slide the hands back. Inhale, press into the hands, lift the heart. And then exhale, press back. You can come up through table, or you can bring the hips all the way to the heels, or you can find your way all the way back to downward facing dog with any steps in between that make this a comfortable transition. I always say if I knew the Sanskrit term for fix the pants, I would include it, but I don't know what it is. I'm sure it exists though. So once you find your way up to downward dog, inhale up onto the toes and stretch out the feet. Exhale and press the heels back down. Inhale the right leg up, nice and long up behind you. Don't worry about how high up your leg goes. You can bend the knee if you like and open the belly a little bit. Let the foot be heavy, but protect the knee. Be careful, no pain here. And then stretch that right leg back out behind you. Bring the foot down. Inhale the left leg up. Bend the knee if you'd like. That's just an option. Lifting the leg is an option. It's not necessary. It just sometimes feels good. Breathe here and then extend the leg back and place the foot back down. We're going to come forward into plank pose here. Build a little strength and a little warmth. You can work on your knees, and you don't need to do very many of these if you don't want to. You can always find your way to child's pose. As you exhale, press back to downward dog, draw the belly in. Inhale and come forward to plank. So we're going to work with the breath here, connecting your breath and your movement. Really kind of exaggerate pulling the belly in here. Maybe think about pressing that stale air out of the bottom of the lungs. Let the breath become a little bit more audible here. Nice full inhales. Good. And the next time we find that downward dog, pause there. Bring the heels back to the earth, or as close to it as they go. And then begin to walk the hands back to the feet, coming into a standing forward fold. So bend the knees as much as you need to make this transition. And once you find your way up to standing, just relax here for a moment. Now, I know for those of us, including myself, with tight hamstrings, the idea of relaxing here might sound a little absurd. So you can always clasp opposite elbows. You can rest your elbows on your legs as the back and hamstrings slowly start to open up. Good. Now, as you inhale, come up halfway and lengthen through the crown of the head. Nice, long, flat spine. Exhale, look full forward. Inhale, come up halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale and come up halfway. This time place the hands on the legs, let the elbows point out toward the sides, fingertips point together. And then as you exhale, round the back, draw the belly in. So some little mini cats and cows right here. You're not going to have the same range of movement as you do on the floor, but that's okay. This just gives the back a chance to open up, especially if it's a little bit tight. Connecting the breath. So you're welcome to use the legs for a little support here. Try not to push on the knees. The next time the back is round, bend the knees more. And then inhale all the way up to standing. Extend the arms up above the head. Nice and long. Keep the arms extended. Take your right hand and wrap it around the left wrist. And a gentle stretch over to the right. Back to center, switch the hands, and exhale over to the left, press into that right foot. Inhale back to center, and this time release the hands back behind the back, interlace the fingers, and lift the heart. So just like we were talking about in bridge pose, these heart opening poses can be really nice when we're feeling a little down or a little stressed. Close the eyes and open the back of the throat. And just watch the breath move up across the heart. Let the belly expand. And if it feels good to move the head around, to bring the chin gently down toward the chest, or maybe a little bit
carefully side to side. Always move mindfully, slowly with the head and the neck. Inhale and extend the arms above the head. Exhale and fold all the way forward. Nice bend in the knees as you fold here to protect the back. Inhale up halfway. Exhale and fold. And inhale all the way back up to standing. Exhale the hands together in front of the heart. So let's do three more of these on your own breath, your own pace. It doesn't matter if the breath is the same. And if you find that that forward fold feels wonderful and you want to stay there, then do that. If you find that being just upright and lengthened feels better, stay there. This is entirely up to you. It's always easier to follow our own breath with the eyes closed. It's easy to get lost in other people's breath when the eyes are open. If you forget where you're going while you're moving here, don't worry about it. You can take a peek or you can just keep moving with your breath any way that feels good. And the next time you have the hands together in front of the heart, pause there. No rush, finish wherever you are. Let the hands come to rest right on the heart. Soften the shoulders away from the ears. Notice the rhythm of the heart, the rhythm of the breath. Release the arms and move everything around. Shake everything out. How are you gals doing? So far, so good. All right. This always throws me in the studio. Turn and face the windows. No, that doesn't work. So we're going to have you turn and face that way. So if you're doing this at home, you're going to just turn to one side and take the legs out into a nice wide V. Soften the shoulders again, kind of move them around in some circles. And then bring the arms in T. Turn the palms up for a moment just to release the shoulders away from the ears. And now we're going to turn the right toes toward the back of the mat. And you guys are great. Take a peek at your own feet at home and make sure that the heel of the front foot kind of lines up with the instep of the back foot. As you exhale, bend the front knee, come into warrior two. Beautiful. So try not to reach forward, try not to lean ahead. You're just really nice and centered here. Crown of the head lines up directly over the tailbone. And if you find after standing here for a moment that the shoulders tense up, release the arms. You can move them, you can shake them out a little bit. And also check in with your breath here. So are you breathing deeply? Can your exhales be long? If not, then straighten the leg. Take a pause, take a couple breaths, and find your way back. The next time that you inhale, straighten the front leg and bring the arms together overhead. Exhale and find that warrior two again. So move a couple more times here at your own pace with your own breath. Try to think of this as just a beautiful flow from one to the other. The breath is like a big circle. One more warrior two. And then straighten the arms and the leg. Bring the arms together overhead. Now lower the left hand back behind you and stretch the right arm up and over the ears. The hand can tuck behind the back. The hand can find the back of the leg. So this front leg can be straight or bent. You can practice it either way. Nice deep breaths wherever you are. Inhale, bring the arms together overhead. If the front leg is bent, straighten it once again. So we're going to create just a little mini flow here. So as you exhale, bend the front knee, come into warrior two.
Inhale, bring the arms together overhead. And exhale, lower the left hand back behind you and the right arm up and over the ear. Inhale, bring the arms together overhead, straighten the front leg. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, straighten the arms and the leg. Exhale, reverse warrior, bring that hand back, stretch and open. Inhale, up one more time. And exhale, warrior two. Good. Inhale, straighten the front leg. Turn all the toes in the same direction now. Bring the arms together in front of the heart. Sorry, the hands together in front of the heart. Now inhale the arms straight up. Little back bend here. As you exhale, bend the knees and the elbows coming into goddess pose. So keep the heart lifted. Shoulders are soft. Tailbone moves down. Good, beautiful work. Inhale the arms up, straighten the arms, straighten the legs. Little back bend if you'd like. And exhale, bend the knees and the elbows. So moving with the breath here too. You can stay with the knees bent if that feels good. If you love this being up and lifted in that back bend, if that's feeling good to you, stay there for a few breaths. This is a really nice place to send some good energy out into the world. The next time the arms are straight up, pause here. And turn the toes straight ahead. You can have them out a little bit, just be careful of the knees. And as you exhale, fold all the way forward. So there's lots of variation in these wide-legged forward folds. If you'd like to move from side to side, you can bend one knee and then the other, shift the weight. Try to use the whole breath rather than rushing from one to the other. Stillness again in center when you're ready. We're going to walk the hands way out in front, coming into a wide-legged downward facing dog. Let the heart press toward the knees. See if you can close the eyes. Relax the back of the neck. Begin to walk the hands back toward you. Lengthen through the crown of the head. Bend the knees. Bring the hands to the legs or to the low back or the hips, wherever you're comfortable. And slowly inhale up to standing. Take your time as you transition here. Good. Either step or hop your feet back to hip distance. And we'll just move things around a little bit. Shake things out a little bit. When you're ready, we'll go back into that wide-legged stance. And this time we'll turn the left toes forward and check the alignment with the back foot. Bring the arms in T, soften the shoulders away from the ears, and find your warrior two. Soften the jaws. Think about that space between the eyebrows again. Let it go a little bit. Inhale, straighten the leg, bring the arms together overhead. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, legs and arms straighten up above the head. Exhale, warrior two. One more time up. Exhale, warrior two. And then straighten the arms and legs. Bring the right hand back behind you. And stretch the left arm up and over the ear. Again, the right arm can wrap all the way around the back, or it can come to the back leg for a little support. Try to keep a little softness in that front knee so you're not locking it. Good, now inhale, bring the arms together overhead. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, straighten the leg, bring the arms together. Exhale, right hand back behind you, left arm over the ear. So move a few more times here, your own pace. Use those inhales to stretch and open and lengthen. Exhale as we bend. Find your way back to warrior two, pause there. Now we're going to swing the arms up and over, bring the hands down on either side of the front foot. Pivot onto the back toes and step back to downward facing dog. So if you'd like to, you can move through a half vinyasa here if that's something that you do in your practice regularly. Or you can move in and out of plank a couple of times. Whatever you choose when you're ready, please find your way to child's pose. So lots of variations here. If you like, you can bring the arms back behind you. You can bring one ear to the earth. You can make a pillow for your forehead. The arms can extend. So lots of options. Notice where the mind goes when you come to stillness. And do so without judgment. If the mind wanders, just bring the attention back to the inhales and the exhales. On an inhale, begin to lift the heart. Make your way back up to table once again. And a couple breaths of cat and cow here. Maybe move side to side, little circles, whatever you're called to do. And then we'll begin to walk the hands forward out in front of you and bring the forehead down to the earth. So nice long arms, elbows stay lifted away from the mat. Forehead comes down. You can stay up on the knees, or you can bring the hips back toward the heels. Breathing into the shoulders, opening the fronts of the shoulders. And now from here, we'll walk the hands all the way off the right side of the mat. Stretching into the left side if you'd like. You can press the head and the left ear into the left upper arm to really increase and deepen that stretch. See if the exhales can help you soften. Inhale, lift the heart, begin to walk back to center. And we'll move the hands off the other side of the mat. You can pause in between if that feels right. Inhale, walk the hands back to center, and find your way back up to table here. Another breath of cat and cow, get things lined up again. And we're going to come to stillness and step the right foot forward. So bringing the right foot directly underneath the knee, so the ankle and the knee line up. There's two different options for your back leg here. It depends on how flexible you are or how comfortable you are with extending. You can stretch that right leg, or left leg rather, way back behind you if you'd like,
or you can keep the knee directly underneath the hip, nice and square. So both places are great. We're not sinking yet. They're ahead of me in their heads. Go ahead and place your hands on your right leg, please. We'll get there, I promise. Soften your shoulders away from your ears. Good. Inhale the arms up above the head. If you like, you can interlace the fingers. If you like, you can sink forward into that left leg a little bit. Lots of places to be here, but really check on your breath because this is an intense stretch, a very large muscle group. If you notice you're not breathing deeply, then you want to come up. Not going quite so far. Let's bring the hands together in front of the heart once again. If you have, lean forward into that leg and scooch the right foot back a little bit again. Start by turning the gaze over the right shoulder. This can be plenty of twists. There's some balance here as well. If you'd like, you can bring the torso around. You can tuck the left elbow outside of the right leg. So do what you need here. Staying upright and simply turning the head is a beautiful rotation. All these variations are good. You just have to find the best one for you today. And if you'd like to, you can release the left hand to the earth. Extend the right arm up. If you'd like to, you can press that left hand into the mat and curl the back toes under and lift the back knee. Lots of great places to be here. And I realize if you're working on a carpet or some sort of uneven flooring, this might be really challenging. So you might want to keep that back knee down. If the knee is lifted, lower it carefully back to the earth. And then without unwinding, inhale and lift the heart. And slowly unwind back to center. Now from here, let's bring the hands down inside that right foot. Line the fingertips up with the toes. And soften the heart. If you notice your knee wants to lean way out to the side, just scoot your foot over a little bit. Give yourself some more room. No pain in the knee here, please. If you feel any of that, then lift back up. We often stay in these hip openers a little bit longer than other postures to give that space a little bit more time to open. It can be tight, this can be challenging. So again, just keep watching the breath. Notice if it's changed dramatically. It might be a hint to lift the heart to come back up a little bit. One more nice deep inhale, and then begin to lift the heart, come up onto the hands if you're on the elbows. Very slowly, very carefully, begin to stretch the right leg long back behind you. So just kind of scooch it around. Bring the leg all the way across to the other side of the left foot, and turn the gaze over the left shoulder. Inhale, lift the leg up, bring it across, and just extend it just to hip level. Draw the toes in toward the knees.
This is a beautiful place to work. It's good balance. It's good strengthening. If you'd like, you can extend the left arm alongside the left ear. That's not necessary. It's just another place to be. It's good to work both sides of our brains at the same time. If the hand is lifted, lower it down. Bring the knee back down to the mat. And bring the hips all the way back to the heels. Move around. Everybody's got hip stuff going on here. So move around and breathe.
If you'd like a downward dog in between, if that sounds appealing, if you want to stretch the legs out differently, it's always fine.
When you're ready, make your way back to table. And from here, we're going to step that left foot forward. When you're ready, bring your hands to your left leg. And then extend the arms up. You can also interlace the hands behind the head. If you'd like to sink forward a little bit into that knee, it's okay here because this is not a real weight-bearing pose. So it's all right to bring that knee forward a little bit. We were moving into a lunge here. You would always want your knee to stay safely over your ankle.
Now from here, bring the hands together in front of the heart.
If you'd like, you can make adjustments with that front foot to find some balance. Turn the gaze over the left shoulder. Work right here, or you can tuck that right elbow outside of the left leg, and then any other variation that you'd like to find here. Slowly unwind back to center. And then bring the hands down inside the left leg. And let yourself hold here. Try really hard. This is one of those postures where if the eyes are open and you're looking at the mat, you're thinking, why can't I get closer to the mat? It doesn't matter. If you feel stretch, if you feel opening, if you feel change, and that can feel pretty intense. And that's the work. It's not a goal of putting the head down on the earth. Let yourself breathe where you are. To notice any differences from side to side. One more breath here. As you're ready, begin to lift the heart. And then carefully, mindfully, begin to bring the left leg back behind you. Place the toes on the earth, stretch to the heel, and bring the foot across the right foot, and the gaze over the right shoulder. This all happens in phases, you don't have to do it immediately. So coming out of these hip openers is such an important time for deep breath. Cleansing that space. space, opening it back up.
Bring the leg back across to center, extend just to hip level.
You can work right here, or you can extend the right arm alongside the right ear. It's just a different place to be. We'll only be here for a moment.
Lower the hand, lower the knee, bring the hips all the way back to the heels.
Forward, they're behind you.
Coming to table now, just a breath of cat and cow here. And then from here, we'll begin to make our way to seated. So you can cross the ankles and come back that way, or swing the legs around to the side. If you'd like to sit up on the edge of a blanket, you're more than welcome to do so. So we're going to start with the legs stretched out nice and long. And bring the hands back behind you, fingertips pointing ahead, soften the shoulders. Let the elbows start to bend just a little bit. And let the heart open up, maybe letting the hands walk back a little farther, maybe opening a little more. So this is another place you can move into a reverse table or a reverse plank if you would like to. But the most important part here is the heart opening. So you can do that beautifully attached to the earth. If you lift it up, lower back down. Lengthen the legs back out again. So we're going to do choose your favorite forward fold today, because they're hard enough, so we're not going to be mean about it. So you can have your legs stretched. That's just my opinion. They're hard for me. They might not be hard for everybody else. So you can have the feet together, like Linda and Melissa see you both chosen. Way to demonstrate a bunch of different stuff. No. Put your feet together. That's what you wanted.
Oh, this is always good for me.
Okay.
It's always a good choice.
All right.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you. So we're going to find your favorite forward fold. So the soles of the feet can come together, the legs can stretch out, the legs can come out into a wide V. You can sit with the legs crossed. You can move into Janu Shavasana. So whatever sounds appealing to you, take some breaths and then just find a gentle forward fold. Forward folds are soothing, they're calming for the body. They help us to relax and let go. But they don't do any of those things if we try to push into them or pull into them. Find your way back to your inhales and your exhales. One more breath wherever you are, and then begin to lift the heart. Find a comfortable place to sit for a moment. We're just going to sit and be quiet.
bring a little energy into the body today. Turn the palms over on the legs so they're open up toward the sky. If you need a little grounding today, then turn the surface of the palms down onto the legs. Close the eyes if you can, if that's available. And just pause with your breath for a moment. Keeping the eyes closed as much as possible, beginning to bring the soles of the feet to the earth, and slowly find our way down onto our backs. Once you get there, draw the knees into the heart. So before we move into Shavasana, to our final resting pose, if there's anything else that you still need, if you'd like to work into the hips anymore, another bridge pose or an inversion of some kind, go ahead and find 8 or 10 breaths. Transition to somewhere comfortable for your Shavasana. Well, that might mean that the legs are stretched all the way down the mat. If you have been in inversion or you've had yourself in a bridge pose or a supported bridge pose, just give the knees a little hug before you stretch all the way out. Just to soften the low back. Extending the legs down to the corners of the mat, drawing the shoulder blades together on the back. If at home you have a blanket that you're comfortable using, it can be very nice to cover at this point. And just take a few minutes here in stillness, continuing to watch the inhales and the exhales, allowing the body to absorb all of the good work that you've done. some gentle movement back into the body, moving the fingers and toes, and the wrists and the ankles. Take a deep breath in, stretch the arms up above the head, and open the mouth and exhale. Let go of anything you might want to leave behind. Bring the soles of the feet onto the earth, draw the knees into the heart. Give yourself a little hug of rock from side to side. And come to rest somewhere where you're comfortable, either on your side or your back or somewhere in between. Pausing for just a few more moments of stillness. Noticing any quiet or calm or peace. Anything else that you'd like to take with you when you leave your mat? Using the strength of your hands and your arms, making your way up to seated. Keeping your eyes closed for just a few more moments and drawing your hands together in front of your heart. Bowing your chin in slightly, taking a moment of gratitude for yourself, for taking the time to do something so healing in so many ways. Moment of gratitude for one more thing in your life. Allowing that to carry you through the rest of your day. For sharing this practice with me and with each other. Have a wonderful day, evening, night, morning, wherever you are. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thanks, everybody. Sorry we went a little bit over, but I couldn't see how long it had been. So, oh, sorry, there's Linda. Okay, so keep practicing. Keep going to the website, looking for new practices. Thanks, everybody. Bye.
Thanks, everybody.